Peace FM 104.3. Good to meet you.
Now, I mean, me propose it because, look, me share implications, you know, me share the complications, you know, me share the challenges, you know. My brother, on your joke, let's not underestimate what Ghana right now is going through relative to this particular thing. We are walking a tightrope, both government and the country. And I, Nyama may read the confidential records, Nyama may win. Ninia told me one thing. Able to me air politics. Able to me air propaganda and counter propaganda. Indeed, perhaps those things are unavoidable because of the kind of political system we are running and the mindset. And I say this sincerely across the political divide. You see, I'm not too much worried or alarmed about the undue, sometimes crude politicization, propaganda and counter propaganda. But I still believe that we have people in this country, in all the political parties, especially the two major ones, and other stakeholders, who could have aggregated to come to the center and say that, hey, this is what we are going to do. Since termination is almost inevitable, the decision taken, these are consequences. This is the way forward. This is how we should combine and deal with the challenge. A is without prejudice to any identification of issues of liability, assuming they are criminal. Church mercy. Mm. That ought to be dealt with by law. So I am not asking for a situation where if we have evidence that somebody deliberately committed a crime, we should say in unity, let's cover it. I have not advocated for that. Whilst that option is there, and if indeed there's evidence to it, and that for that matter should be exercised, because Ninia can, the culture of deterrence, or can the culture of making people stand, wake up when they are working for the state. So that's not, I'm not excluding it. But I'm saying there, the greater focus should be on how sometimes, as a nation, we can come together and tackle some of these challenges. 190 is no big money, in my candid opinion, but saying the implications in terms of interconnectivity to the economic structure, it has some impact, at least in the immediate terms. And if you have a national consensus as to how to deal with that, it's better than the heat that brings no light, which we are experiencing.
Would there be any national consensus? The last time I was saying it, as a usual, then hear about together as well. Kwame, not the last time.
Well,
there are some issues where it needs a national dialogue. Sit down.
This compact, before we do concession agreement, documentation, a lot of stakeholders meetings took place. From the Mahama administration to the Akufo-Addo administration before they finalized. Political parties, parliamentarians, industry captains, labor unions, traditional rulers were all brought on board at different fora across the country. They even did some original basis. So that principle is there. Post the transfer date, I recognize difficulties. That same aggregate in terms of consultation could be of use and help. Yes, you can hear the NDC at press conferences using all sorts of adjectives. To be honest with you, if the MPP were in opposition, I'm sure they would have done the same.
I'm not too sure. We will do one that has basis.
Well,
we will not just be on a sliding slope and just be throwing all kinds of words into the air.
What I mean is that, well, I'm
we take the good people seriously.
In Namibia, I'm sure some elements would have happened that would still be what the NDC are doing. I'm very sure about that. And I can recollect two classic examples and tell the gentleman who sent the text that I shouldn't do recollection, that I'm about to do it. Say, STL, or STX.
Yes, STX.
Yes, I remember the debate that went on, because I remember where I stood, and I was pleading with members of the MPP and their communicators to at least come to the middle and understand some of the challenges the Mills administration was facing. I remember distinctly on this station, on Metro, and on News 5, the 3 billion Chinese thing. And not that the issues being raised were negative or not principled, but I was asking, because see, some of the issues the NDC are raising, you can't run away from the fact that government itself admits that there was fraud in procuring the guarantee, the insurance guarantee.
Yes.
Yes, that's an issue. Whether we like it or not, it's an issue which must be dealt with. I'm asking that people must look at that issue dispassionately, in fairness, and agree. Well, yeah, then you will not be blaming government for that. They raise the issue. Look, I've mentioned 9 year due diligence before. The documentations I have seen shows that if one postponed the deadlines and timelines about 3 times till March 1st clocked in, it was established and is documented. I brought some here. That post the transfer date, due diligence must continue. And the ECG was continuing with it. That's how come they detected the discrepancy. And it's documented. Some of the Americans, some of them are using that. They look, so still give PDS the chance to do a new guarantee. Tema mission. Because they are saying that they can understand how it happened. But for them, it's not a fatal injury to the integrity of the transaction. The Ghana government disagrees with that. Says it's a fatal injury because it was a condition precedent. Mati Nkofubi Ikada, that was changed into condition subsequent. It's not true.
At all.
It's not true.
At all.
What changed was the nature of the guarantee.
Yes.
Look, if the insurance guarantee had turned out to be genuine, done by the right agencies, there will still be no problem.
Yes. Despite the fact that it's one and same.
Yes, but the truth is that in changing it from bank guarantee to insurance guarantee was the problem. No, it is the fact that the insurance guarantee is defective. Because a bank guarantee could also have become defective. And that was not changed from condition precedent to condition subsequent. Because those two were fundamental. It's the nature, the structure that changed. But not the principle there. Procure this, submit it for transfer date to become effective.
BFM 104.3, good to meet you.